tell me now, as a Rasta, what is your feeling about being Jamaican?
Being Jamaican? Yeah. Being Jamaican. Well, like, you're going on, Neville. Being Jamaican. I don't say being Jamaican, you know. I see myself as a Rasta, being Rasta.
Uh-huh.
You know? Yeah. So Jamaica is Jamaica. Africa is Africa. I'm an Rasta.
Uh-huh. You don't have any boundaries?
My boundaries. No, well, I must pick a place on earth where I know I must live. Uh-huh. And I know I want to live near my father. And my father lives in Ethiopia.
Yeah.
So I must live where my father is.
Literally? In other words, literally, you hope to go and live in Ethiopia someday?
I don't hope. We're going. Mm. And near.
Uh-huh.
This is 1973, going near to 74, uh-huh. You know. And just say, before one of my word pass away, heaven and earth crash, mm-hmm. Dig. And him say I'm gone for prepare a place that where he is, I and I shall be there also.
Bob, listen, every day nowadays we read about famine in Ethiopia. What you say to that now?
Right. Great.
Everybody
I said great.
About
I said great. If you don't know God, you're going to suffer and dead. No God, no partial, regardless where you depend on earth. If you're there in Ethiopia, in him palace, and you don't know, say him is the Almighty, you suffer. Regardless where you're there, God no partial eye. No, I could have starved and suffered too, but I know Jah.
For hunger and starvation.
Now, it's Bob Marley and the Wailers. You write such a lot of material for the group. You have such a lot to do with it. Are you committed to the group?
Well, yes. The group is the Wailers. Well, for some reason, them say Bob Marley and the Wailers. I never tell no one to say that. From no time at all. But maybe for some reason, them do it, you know. Well, I man is the Wailers, you know. And you just set race. Right now, and I will play some music, you know, I'm just going to play some music until then. Until what happened, it just happened, because I don't plan, like, you know, because when man plans, I wipe out.
Right, right.
Play some music, just a reggae music. Play some music, just a reggae music. Say you want it, hey, Mr. Music.
All right, but what about songwriting? You write such a lot of music. Different people write music in different ways. Some sit down and write the words and then put the music to it. Some write the music, then drop in the words after. Do you have a process? And exactly what is it, if you have one?
Well, it grew together, you know. It's like, first time I try write a song was the first time I try play the guitar. And so, I can't write a song without the guitar. But it really grew together. I really just not like steered my guitar, you know. But it just happened. It's just inspiration come true, man, you know. And it just, because I personally could write a, it could look like I could write a woolly patroon, it look like, you know. But I pick special tune for write.
Yeah.
Because
yeah.
A man can think of plenty of things, you know.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yes, I understand.
Wanna know how you got to face reality, though I try to find the
end. Listen, you know, I know you had a close association with Johnny Nash, who has done quite a lot of your tunes. And we hear people talking and say, boy, I wonder if Johnny Nash ever treats our Jamaican man right. What exactly is the situation? We're quite free on this program.
Well, them give me some money the other day, you know, and what am I for signing the agreement with them, man? Really, I check it out, like,
yeah.
You know, because, you know, it's like, me don't want to say nothing bad about them, and still right. me don't have nothing much good to say.
Right. But what do you think about Americans taking the reggae and doing it and making big money out of it, like Johnny Nash has done and Paul Simon and a couple other people? What do you think about that?
Well, them do something which you, these people out here, I try to kill way off. We couldn't do, right? Uh-huh. Because them people out there too wicked.
Yeah.
No, never, them things make me vex, like, you know.
I understand.
You know what I mean?
I can understand, yeah.
Because I watch, look how much good artists in Jamaica. You know what I mean? And look what it take for a guy just say, because them is guys, say, all right, make me get some good recording done and do a thing with it. Just a hustle of people when you come in and come to 15 tune in 3 hours.
Yeah.
You know? And so a guy spend $15,000 to make a album. And when the album comes, it's still a million.
Yeah, yeah.
So him don't lose because in real stadium, no guess nothing. In stadium, do him that do.
Yeah. So you mean that the people here wouldn't spend the money on us?
Them never want to do that.
I see, yeah.
Them wait till when time Johnny Nash and them guys go on with that thing, and certain guys them say, well, if a guys are coming now, and them hardly even want to do it.
Yeah.
We have the one studio and all of that, where we are going to try to get right now, one studio.
Alright, but
because we want it, Jamaica, we have it.
You want a studio?
Yeah, that's because we want to make music. You have too much man out there. We have to go through too much other things, just to classes,
yeah.
You know?